Hey YouTube, so I have a smaller log there. That thing's probably, I don't know, I didn't measure it yet. It's probably about 8 inches in diameter. It's not going to give me a very big cant, so I'll cut out of it what I can. For right now, I have the backhoe loaded and I want to get rid of a bunch of these cutoffs then. So I'm going to cut this just to get rid of the flitches, and then I'll take the backhoe over to my one neighbor that cuts everything up for firewood. Okay guys, so I had been asked a question, where do I start cutting the first cut? And since this is a 9-inch log, I should be able to get 6-inch cant out of it, although it has a bend and different things in it. So the thing that I do is I measure roughly across there at the other end, 6 inches. And if you look at that, it's about right here. That's where I would start to cut that over there. Now these both ends are the same size, believe it or not. It's just that the log has a bunch of knots and stuff in it. So I'm not sure what this wood's gonna look like, but I'm gonna try cutting it and see. I'm down, you know, a little further than where it would have been. Hold on, I'll measure it in a second here. Anyway, one of the reasons for that is because it has a bend in it, a little bend in the log. Yeah, so I'm 8 inches there. I would have been better if I could have been up higher, but I'll probably get a 4-inch cant out of this one way, maybe 6 inches the other. cut 6 inches up off the bump rail at the far end, which you can see it's not really down far enough. So I'm gonna go down another 2 inches and I'll just make that 4 inches there, because it's not gonna work as 6 inches. Guys, I was getting some questions about the kind of blades I use. These are the Wood Miser double hard regular blades. It has a 10 inch angle on it, I believe. I'm not changing that because I have no problem with those blades. They work really well. No reason for me to change. I get nice straight cuts for quite a few logs, really, before I have to sharpen. Both ends of this board are up off the pan, so you can tell that there's a little bend to this thing. So I have 4 1/4 inches there. I'm going to turn that now, and then I'm going to go ahead and cut 4-inch boards out of that. And I could have gone down a little bit lower on that. I think I'll go down one more inch on it and get rid of the wane on this side. And that'll make the rest of those boards fairly nice. Bending, so it might be better if I turn this to the side and cut it the other way. I'll probably get some 6-inch boards out of it. I gotta turn it all the way around and cut it and see. Get out of a cant is not always what you measure. A lot of times it's just what it's not always what you measure. A lot of times, you know, it depends on what your log is. So now I'm gonna turn that 90 degrees and see how those boards end up if they stay laying flat. About turning the log there, this is not really, it's coming up, but it's very slightly. So that'll be a flatter board as I drive. Little things like that are something you want to watch out for, because if you keep cutting, you know, sometimes we get selfish and we want wide boards, and sometimes you just can't get them. from cutting that before when it had a little bow to it. That's why I'm ending up with these two pieces from each end. The middle is 1 inch, but the two ends were like an inch and, I don't know, 3/16, so I cut them a little bit. So at least there's four boards there. And they're not bad looking. Alright, so I've got to be able to take that wood over to my neighbor. And then I have some oil to change, which is why I'm wearing some really ratty clothing here, so I can change oil without worrying about what I get wet. Alright guys, I'll see you later. Have a good one.